So friends, how many of us set resolutions when the new year comes? How many of us have been typically setting resolutions? Okay, this year, this is what I'm going to change. No, Sandhya ji says no. Mala, what about you? Mohini ji, Ranjana?
No, I don't.
That's wonderful. Divya, what about you?
Achievable ones.
Achievable ones. How many of us used to do it and have given up?
Me.
Sandhya used to do it. Okay. Oh, so most people used to do it. Ranjana, what about you?
I still do it.
You still do it. Wonderful. Wonderful. That's excellent. So friends, I was somebody who used to never do it. Okay. And I have now started come to kind of doing it. So everybody has their different ways and absolutely fine the way that we actually are moving. But today we are really going to talk a little about this science and really how to kind of move ahead with this. And we are of course going to also meditate about this. Welcome, Sanjeev ji.
Namaste, madam. Namaste. Nice to meet you. Nice to see you.
Yes, yes, yes. So, Divya, we can start recording now. Okay. Yeah. So, friends, as we will be coming towards the end of the year, right? Just our life is such every when we have heard that change is the only constant. There are so many endings and beginnings that come, so many changes that come. And in fact, we as human beings also, we think I am this person, we define ourselves, but we are also constantly changing. Life is such and we are such because we are also part of life. Life is what is flowing in us. It is not like a fixed thing. It's more like a river. So when you're stepping into the river, there's a master who used to say that when it is like river. When you step into the river, you're never touching the same water a second time, right? So we are also changing, right? Now, when there is change already happening in nature, it is very supportive also for us to make changes, any changes that we want to make. So when people would say that you meditate early morning or when the sun is setting, why? Because a change is happening from sunset, when the sun is setting or when the sun is rising, there is a change happening. And that is a time where it's actually easier also for you to shift gears, for you to start going with it. So time also to make changes. And that's the wisdom why we also actually do introspection. Typically, when there is a beautiful time for introspection. And once you have introspected, then whatever that you want to now grow in your life, it's good to set intentions. It's good to have some resolutions as to how I want to now channelize my energy in this coming phase. So that really is also the time to introspect, right? Because when we've all heard about the attraction law of manifestation of karma that we are, right? Friends joining, welcome friends, thank you for joining. Merry Christmas. And as we are moving towards the new year, friends, we're talking about resolutions. You know, typically, right from childhood, we've all heard about resolutions. And classically, so many times, what has happened is that people would set resolutions. They would try to do some new things. And if you ask them by 15th of January, that fever is gone, right? They've stopped doing that. They've gotten back to their old classic ways. And then they've kind of forgotten about the new year, and the year is actually just going past the way that we have become. So as we've spoken earlier in other sanghas also that we are addicted to how we have become. Our childhood has shaped us. By the time that we've become an adult, we've got our fixed ways. And very likely we will keep manifesting the same things again and again, unless and until we actually examine, we introspect. We see what is it that I want to change this year? What is it that I want to really change in my life? And as we are actually setting resolutions, friends, resolutions, so many times when I've actually worked with people and for myself as well in the beginning, resolutions was more about wish list. When people would say, okay, this is my resolution. If you look into their resolution, you know, what they really want, so many times they were actually just putting out their wish list. Resolution is not wish list, right? Resolution, which comes from the word resolve. So yes, initially you pay attention to what you want. What are your wishes? What would you like to create in your life? Because we are full of this life force. It's like you're driving your car, right? It's like you're deciding, okay, where do I want to take my car now? So these are the different pathways available. Where would I like to navigate towards? So you're setting an intention. You're saying, this is where I would like to go towards. But to make that change, there has to be a resolve. Those changes will start coming when you actually also then pay attention to the next step. What is it that you are going to do for that? Okay. So the most important thing, friends, we are actually, like I said, we are addicted to how we've become. We are addicted when we say, hame iski aadat hai, I'm habituated to this. That means that we do this again and again and again. Our resolution, when we say this is what I would like, now that comes from conscious mind. So your conscious mind will give attention, do a little introspection. And then when I say I want these changes, okay, now that conscious thought that this is what I want, we have to train our subconscious. We have to do some things again and again and again so that they become part of our subconscious. One beautiful way of doing that is practicing something for 40 days. In every religion, there are these practices, you know, whenever they would give some practice, they would say, you practice, somebody says for 40 days, most common, sometimes 21 days and sometimes 60 days. The idea is that for when you're doing something for 40 days, and this 40 days is without missing a single day. So your attention is going there, right? You know, I have to do this. And then when you're doing it, so this neurons are firing. The same thing you're doing again and again, the neurons start firing together. They start wiring together, right? Slowly, then it'll become part of your system. So till the time this new thing, which you now realize is something that is important for you, becomes a habit for you, becomes your natural way of being, you have to somewhere give attention to it. You have to probably, you know, you can create your checklist. Okay, this is what I need to do every day. So this beautiful time, friends, that we have now, our meeting, you know, between Christmas and New Year's, is an amazing time for introspection. So because this is the time for introspection, you're not actually going to do a meditation for manifestation. We have a recorded meditation for manifestation on our YouTube channel. But what I thought today is that we will do a meditation for actually just connecting. We'll connect to all our chakras. Okay. Because whatever we have manifested till now, whatever is already happening in our life, we need to introspect. We need to give it attention. We need to learn from it. Okay. So the different chakras of our body, okay, which are the energy centers. The seven chakras, are we all aware about it? You can just raise your hand, right? Now, beautiful. So these centers, for example, the heart center, that is governing all the organs around it. So there is endocrine gland associated with each chakra and the different organs which are there in that area. it is actually just energizing all those paths. So what we are going to do is we are going to connect to each of the chakras. Right now, we are not going to go into what each chakra is connected to. That's okay if you don't know. But just giving energy there, just keeping our awareness there, allowing a relaxed awareness. Okay, we're just going to bless this chakra. We're just going to bless this energy center. Okay, and it may happen that a visual comes to you, an insight comes to you, a thought comes to you. Just watch it with love. Okay, everything that is coming, everything that's happening within us is here to inform us about what's happening. It may inform you about something that you have to change. It may inform you about something that you need to learn from. It may inform you about something that you need to say goodbye towards. Okay, so you can actually introspect later, because we are saying that we are in this phase where we introspect and we can start saying goodbye to whatever is not serving. And we can sow the seeds for what we really want to develop in our life. Okay, so as we will move ahead with this, is there any questions that anybody has, my dear friends?
Yeah, Dr. Preeti, what happened? You make a resolution, then you don't fulfill it due to some reason, maybe.
Yes.
So what is the reason, and then why it happened that way?
Good question, Palaji. Palaji, typically, because we have done some things over and over again, okay, it has become a part of our subconscious. Okay, now what happens is that our cells are craving, are used to that reality. Okay, for example, a person is an angry person, okay, and this person says, now my New Year resolution, I'm never going to be angry. Okay, I am not going to get angry at anybody. This is my resolution. Okay, now when we have felt emotions, we have certain kind of thoughts. When the thought is the language of the brain, okay, then we are feeling certain image. For example, this person feels that this person is not listening to me. Okay, she doesn't love me. She's not listening to me. Okay, and he gets angry. Now, immediately the thought has come, the feeling is there. With the emotions that we feel, there are chemicals that are being released. Our cells have received those chemicals for years together. Just as we may be addicted to the tea or the coffee, or probably talking to somebody, okay, which is something we do every single day, we are now so used to it, right? Our cells are also used to those chemicals. That's what we say, that we are addicted to that. Okay. Now what happens is when he says that I'm going to change. Okay. Somewhere the cells start getting uncomfortable. What's really happening? Is it really going to happen? Okay. Now his natural way, he's learned this way, that moment something is going against him, somebody is not listening to him, he gets angry. The anger comes out. He throws a tantrum, okay? And that probably makes the other person want to listen to him, okay? Now, somewhere when he's trying to change initially, it's not going to be so easy, okay? So what we need to do is, Palaji, we need to firstly give ourselves small steps, okay? For example, when somebody has been an angry person, it may happen that, okay, they've set this intention. Okay, now they are still getting angry, but what happens is earlier, if they would actually realize it after one day or after 6 hours, they realize it after 2 hours. That is a positive. Okay, so this is what classically happens. Then what will happen is slowly they will realize it after half an hour, or slowly after that they will still say it, and then they will immediately realize, oh my God, why did I say it? And then slowly it will happen that the word is just coming, they really want to say it, but they stop themselves. Okay, and then slowly it will happen that they actually are not even saying it, they just are able to bring the awareness right at that time, they take a little time. They say, okay, I will just come back to you. Okay, I'm just getting angry, but let me take a little time. So these are small ways, small changes will start happening. Okay, so now what we need to do, we need to be just how you would be with a child. We need to be with ourselves just the way that is, right? Yes. That appreciate those small changes that are happening. Don't get disheartened.
Thank you. Right? Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Friends, any other question?
If you make an intention, for example, a resolution, will the universe actually really helping us to sort of, you know, bring things to help you out?
Yes, absolutely. So we are actually, like they say, we are the creator's child. We are also creators. We are part of that, you know, there is oneness. We are part of that same energy. And actually, we are all that creator energy only. We are individuated aspects of that same one being. Okay. And actually, he wants us, or she wants us, to really be this creator. But the truth is that we are scared of our own power. Imagine today, if you become very powerful, if, you know, today if somebody tells me you have to be the Prime Minister of India tomorrow, I will be scared because I don't know how to manage. I don't know how to manage the country, right? We don't know sometimes how to really manage anything. I don't know how to manage so many things, right? Now, we have to learn to manage this energy, our emotions, our thoughts, right? So somewhere we are scared of actually how powerful we are. So we will keep crying. We'll keep saying this person is doing this to me. But actually we have, what we are doing is that when we start learning to manage all our stuff inside, the energies within, right? And of course, in doing that, we need to pay attention to past. How is it that I have been handling my energies? How is it that I handle my relationships, my emotions? So when we are paying attention to that, we learn from that. So this is really the process of actually becoming the creator, becoming powerful. Okay, we are creating our reality. Friends, so many times what happens is when we are saying that, okay, I want this in my life. Okay. There is especially in the Indian traditional, this thing, right? There was this thing that desire, don't desire. How many of us have heard this or have had this conflict? That's wonderful, right? Now, why is it? So here we are saying that we are creating our reality. There is one set of thinking which is saying resolution, say what is it that you want. And there is another set saying don't desire, right? Now, the fact is that actually we are part of that creator. So we actually have all of it inside. Supposing I want something, what will happen if I get it? I'll feel abundant, right? Now, when we desire it, what happens is actually we are feeling not abundant. We are desiring it because I'm feeling not abundant. Okay. In the physical reality, the way things are, we experience that there is a divide. If I want to be loved, if I'm waiting for somebody, a relationship in my life, because this person will make me feel loved. Basically, we are not feeling loved, right? So somewhere we are feeling a divide. So it is good to have an intention. But if we are staying in the desire, actually what's happening is we are staying in the lack. Okay. So we actually can pay attention to supposing, where did you lose that love? Where is it that this lack of love is coming from? Right? Because actually it's not lost. Deep within, it's actually there. If it is the truth that we are connected to the source, if the source is already there in us, right, then where did we lose it? What is blocking it? Right? So as we set an intention, friends, as we will set our resolutions, so you may not necessarily have, okay, this is my resolution, but the intention, okay, this is what I would really like to do. this is how I would love to use my energies in this year. This is a beautiful aspect I would love to see grow in my life. If you just pay attention to that, right? Now, what is it that you need to do towards that? You can also pay attention. What is stopping me from feeling that? Like I said, feeling loved, right? Where did I lose it? So we will also need to kind of reflect within, allow whatever is there in the past, because all the river, the flow is already there. What's blocking it is coming from the past. So allow that to come. Allow yourself to see it and release it. Okay. Any other questions, my dear friends? Thank you, Balaji, for those beautiful questions.
Hello, Preeti.
Anji.
Just wanted to ask you, before chakra healing, any restriction for the food, whether you have to be empty stomach or you can have after meals?
So we are not really doing any strong breathing techniques right now. Sometimes in chakra meditations, we breathe strongly into the chakras. So at that time, it's not advisable to be, having a full meal and doing it after that.
Okay.
But right now, what we are going to do is we are just going to be with the breath initially, and then just take the awareness from one chakra to the other. Okay. And just blessing what is, okay, whatever is there, and kind of allowing that shift to happen if anything needs to shift.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank
so because you. I had little early dinner, so that's why I just wanted to make things clear. Okay, is it okay? If I follow whatever that you are guiding?
Absolutely. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So friends, are we ready to move towards meditation now? That's wonderful. So we can close our eyes, friends. Just be in a comfortable posture. Meditation is all about just being with yourself, knowing yourself, loving yourself. We are all in the process of growth, accepting and loving whatever has been is the sutra. So as you close your eyes, bring your awareness to your breath, your natural breath, watching the incoming and outgoing breath. With gentle awareness, loving awareness, just being with your breath, you're taking these moments to be with yourself. And as we are doing that, you're going to have an absolutely non-judgmental attitude. Pure awareness, watchfulness of what is. Be with the breath. Watch the breath. You're watching the sensations which are there at the nostrils or the abdomen rising and falling with the breath. Or you're watching the entire track as the breath comes in and goes out. The sensations are there and you are watching. There is the body where the sensations are happening. And there's a part of you which is watching this. Similarly, when thoughts come, you can watch them from a little distance, unengaged, as if clouds passing through the sky. You can watch your own thoughts. And just as we can watch our thoughts, our body, we also watch our emotions. The emotions that sometimes we are feeling, allow yourself to now become aware of how at one level you may be feeling that, experiencing that. And there's the aspect of you which is watching. Absolutely relaxed with what is. And just as you now experience this aspect of yourself, which is not attached, which is beyond the sensations, the experiences of the body, which is beyond the thoughts and the emotions. This awareness. You're going to now take this awareness. You're going to watch the different aspects of yourself, the chakras. You're going to just take the awareness to the chakras. Allow yourself to bring your awareness to the root chakra, the first chakra, which is at the base of the spine, our sit bones. Keeping your awareness there, allow there to be a relaxed awareness, as if you're becoming aware of the entire area around there. And relaxing. And just as if this breath is going there, your breath, which is full of love, which is full of this creative energy, prana, that is coming into you from the loving universe, is just moving into this chakra. Just be there, relaxed. just with a state of acceptance and watchfulness. Be there, relaxed awareness. And just another minute, keeping your attention there. As you feel ready, the awareness starts to come up now into the sacral center, the second chakra, which is 2 inches below your navel. And just keeping your awareness there, a relaxed awareness, as if becoming aware of the area all around it. As if feeling the breath energizing, blessing this part. A relaxed awareness. And just allow any sensations, any emotions that may be coming. Any spontaneous image that may come is okay. Just watch it. Take a note of it. Nothing to do. Nowhere to go. Just be with yourself. With whatever that's happening within. And as you feel ready, you're going to allow the awareness to now come up into the third chakra, the Manipura center, the solar plexus. Keeping your awareness there, a relaxed awareness. As if the loving, gentle breath going into that part. And your awareness of this chakra and the area around it. Relax into it. Just spending another minute there. Trust any impressions that may come up, any feelings, any images. And as you feel ready, allow your awareness to further come up into the heart center, the center of your chest, the fourth center. The center of love, of interconnectedness. And allow yourself to feel that love is coming into the center with every breath. A relaxed awareness of the area all around it. Feel the love expanding. Watch what is happening. We love our creations into life. With love, we bring our creation into life. Allow the awareness to now move up further into the throat center, the Vishuddha Chakra, the center of expression, creativity. And as you just keep your awareness there, breathe into it. Feel the loving breath going there. Allow yourself to relax. Keep your awareness there for another couple of minutes. Trust whatever is coming for you. If your mind wanders away in between, simply bring it back to the breath, to the center where we are. Know that you are the master. Command the mind to come back. And as you're there, feeling now ready for the awareness to further move up into the third eye, feel that happen. Allow the awareness to shift to the Agya Chakra, the third eye center, the center of the head or where the ponytail would be. Keep your awareness there. Relaxed awareness. Agya Chakra is also the center. As we say Agya, it's like the CEO. When you strengthen the will, when you resolve for something, and when you say to yourself with that resolve, the entire body listens to it. Allow yourself to just be there with the energy going into the center. Loving energy moving towards the center, the third eye. And this loving energy that's entering you with the breath, And the shower of energy that you may be feeling from the crown is also taking your awareness now to the crown center, the top of your head, the Sahasrara. Bring your awareness here, keep your awareness here. Allowing yourself to receive the love of the universe, the blessings of the universe. You are loved. You are blessed. With this loving energy, with this energy blessing us, we look at our past and we learn from that. We love our past. Carrying forward the lessons, we can say goodbye to whatever that may not be serving us anymore. Just spending another minute in the silence. Just being with your breath now. Keeping your awareness with the breath. You may feel the awareness coming down. You can bring your awareness down to the sixth chakra, fifth chakra, down to the fourth chakra. These blessings are receiving. Each of the chakras are being blessed with this energy. Third chakra, as if a shower coming down, this beautiful energy coming down the centers. The second chakra and the root chakra. And you may take three long deep breaths, getting ready to come back, rubbing your palms together, covering your eyes, slowly coming back. Welcome back, my dear friends. Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Friends, anybody would like to share any experience? And because we are already at 7:45, what I'll do is, if there's any Divya, any announcement that we had to give. Okay. The Inner Child Workshop, friends, we are having the Inner Child Workshop in Mumbai on the 22nd, 23rd of January. So hopefully, with permissions, we will be continuing with that. Please, if you have any friends in Mumbai, please suggest to them, anybody joining. And anybody would like to share their experience, ask any questions. And because it's already 7:45, anybody needs to leave, we're okay with that. Thank you so much for joining. Yes, Dipali.
Yes, thank you, Preeti. It was such an amazing, and I could just feel a lot of energy and energy. I've not been meditating well, but now today I felt so good going and being with myself. One thing I wanted to ask is, what is it when the infinite sign is vertical? What is it saying when the infinite sign comes as a vertical thing?
Where did you feel it?
Particular. I'm doing it like this. Yeah.
Okay. So the infinity sign or the eight is as above, so below. Okay. So it could, of course, it could be a sign of abundance. It could also be a sign of, like we said, that as above, so below. So we actually look into what is and learn from it. Yeah. So just seeing that as above, so below. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Dipali. Friends, one very important thing. If somebody was to ask me, okay, resolution I don't do, but if there's one thing that, you know, as a resolution, what should we do? It is to meditate. Because it's when we are meditating, we're really connecting to the source. So many times when people don't do any resolutions, no, nothing at all, but just meditate, their life starts changing. Okay. And so many times, because we spoke about the addictions, we actually give up meditating because a part of us is actually trying to stop us, wants us to be there, right? So meditate each and every single day. Even if you're not doing anything else, just have at least this resolution. I'm going to meditate every single day of my life. Okay. So thank you. Yes. That's beautiful, Ankit. Thank you for sharing.
It was wonderful. It was really wonderful. Thank you so much. And I just wanted to ask you, will you be sharing this recording with us?
Yes, Divya, there'll be this recording on the YouTube.
Yes, ma'am, I will be uploading on YouTube.
Yes, so tomorrow you can actually visit our YouTube channel and you can find it there.
I have a question, please. The question is that what came up at the throat chakra was, I need to have better communication. Now, how can I convert that into a resolution?
You can actually pay attention to it. Okay. For example, what is happening at the communication level? Okay. So when you will actually sit down with this very beautiful question and actually can help so many people, just sit down. Okay. What's happening? So for example, you are scared of hurting the other. So I'm actually not saying what I'm actually feeling. Because I'm scared that if I say the truth that I don't want to do XYZ that the other person wants me to, then the other person will feel hurt. For example, I'm just saying when you pay attention. And now, okay, so what will happen? I pay attention to that and then say, how can I actually shift it? Because this fear could be coming from childhood. You know, as children, we are actually trying to be obedient children. I'm giving you a random example, okay? And I have learned that I have to keep doing everything that the other person asked me to do. Right. Now, in this case, how would I communicate? So the next time this person asks me to do this, when I don't feel like, what is a nice way of me actually not hurting the other, but also communicating what I'm feeling?
True.
So then when you're paying attention, you will understand, oh, this is what another way that I could do it. So you're actually now already thinking about it. You're saying, yes, this is how I could do it. So the next time, it will not be that again, you've just gone by the same way. When the situation happens, you can say, okay, let me just take a minute. You don't have to immediately, you know, give the answer, but you can actually apply this then. Okay. So the area that may have come, whatever has come for you, for each person, actually now sit and contemplate. And you can work in this way. So when we say Agra Chakra, the neocortex, that's like the CEO, that's the center of creativity. Think about it. How can I be different now? If I'm an angry person, how can I deal with it in a different way? So actually pay attention to that. Does that help, Mohiniji?
Very, very, very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Dr. Priti, further to this question, what I felt was, you know, in my solar plexus, fear and depressed feeling. Whereas in my heart, I had a lot of gratitude and abundance feeling. So why this contradiction? I don't understand.
So there is no contradiction. The gratitude is there, but there is fear as well.
Oh, that means both feelings are there.
Both are there.
So which one am I saying?
You felt the gratitude, which is great. Allow that to grow. That fear that you felt, you need to see where is it coming from. What is the fear about? Or just start, you know, right now, just start paying attention to it. Okay, I'm ready to see deeper. What is the root of that fear?
Thank you. That means I work on the fear first, is it? Then the gratitude.
The gratitude you continue to feel. There is no contradiction.
All right.
So each center, there will be something. So for example, I may feel a lot of gratitude and I may feel confusion. I may feel gratitude and I may feel anger also. Right? So it's not that the gratitude is there, the interconnectedness is there. That's beautiful. But also you take the feedback from each chakra. Yeah?
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, friends. Anybody would like to share? I've received messages. Thank you so much. Hi, Hemaraju. Yes, please. You can unmute yourself, Hemaraju.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
During the meditation, you are guiding me through starting from root chakra. I have seen a lot of chakras starting from root chakra, like starting root chakra, star, like star button star. And then came to the second chakra, sacral chakra, six petals, like orange color. When I went to third chakra, Manipura, some flower burning within me. Burning, I can see the completely, but some, some happening within me, some little bit, I see the sun, whole of the sun. Then I moved to the fourth chakra, like another chakra. It was circle green color. Then I am going to the fifth chakra, some of throat in blue color and some little red dots within me. Then I was feeling very crying in this moment. I tried to let the crying, but the crying stop. Then I entered the fifth chakra, like other chakra. Some fears happening within me, like to the sea, like this. Finally, I enter the seventh stage chakra. It is very like divine energy flowing within me. Then that energy completely absorbing totally. Then I felt very complete, like relaxed more.
That's beautiful, Hemaraju. Amazing. Amazing experience, and thank you for sharing. Friends, thank you so much and have a wonderful, wonderful new year. And see you again in January.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Dr. Preeti.
Bye bye.